R.E.M. is my all-time favorite band. They have, from their musical styles to the wild experimentation that they were willing to take through the harmonies and just everything that they were able to do. I don't love all of their albums, but I love most of their albums, and they have had possibly, outside of Cademan's, one of the biggest outsized influences on me personally. I would say lyrically they have too, but my goodness, if you can understand Michael Stipe's lyrics, especially from those first few albums, props to you. I know that as they got older, as they progressed in their career, you could understand Michael Stipe more. You could understand what he was writing about. It was still out there in some ways. And I wouldn't necessarily say that I resonated so much with the lyrics, but I understood, or at least I appreciated what he was going for. I know that I didn't always understand, especially when I was a teenager. I didn't understand all that he was writing about. When I think about albums like Automatic for the People or Monster, I love Monster, but I can definitely tell you that I am not there. I didn't understand it all lyrically when I was a teenager when that album came out in 1995, but I love that album. And New Adventures in Hi-Fi is, I love their 90s work. I really do love their 90s work. I love the 80s work. Their post-Bill Berry stuff is a little bit harder to grasp, but I really like how they closed out their career. They closed out strong, in my opinion. And R.E.M. has had probably an outsized influence on me just because of the way that the members were able to work together, how long they stayed together, how they were able to just experiment and change things on the fly. You know, I think about the work that they did on the album Out of Time and where they were all playing different instruments. That is amazing to me, that they didn't necessarily see themselves set in a role. I unfortunately never got to see them live. That's one of my regrets in life, is that I never saw R.E.M. live.